I'm pretty sure you've never seen one of these before. In fact, it may be the only one of its kind in the world. Any guesses? Working titles include...
Crap rafts. This boat is a toilet. Mr. Grumpy's curious poop-eating boat machine. Poop and paddle.
It's builder.
My name's Adam Katzman.
Completed it earlier this week, and just to be explicit.
It's a floating toilet that uses bioremediation to clean the toilet water that comes out of it.
If you're wondering why, well, it's not for the money.
Toilet paddle boat probably is not the most lucrative business plan.
Adam's a green builder. He converted this houseboat, parked across the dock at the same Queens Marina, into an off-grid structure.
And in the end, the water system on that boat is something that I became really excited about.
So he started studying water treatment in books and online, and this is his next experiment. And it's also a timely conversation piece. A few weeks ago, a fire at a New York sewage processing plant resulted in loads of raw sewage being dumped into the harbor.
Which became a huge issue, but it's no different than what happens every time it rains in New York.
The problem is called combined sewage overflows.
Rainwater and sewage travel through the same pipes, and when it rains, the pipes get too full and they're designed to overflow into the waterways.
Whereas Poop and Paddle is a self-contained sewage treatment plant, although it's sized only for one person's use. So here's how it works.
So rainwater falls off the lower roof and goes into a holding tank for the toilet. To bring water in, you pump that lever, and then to flush the toilet, you pull that lever. You plunge the toilet water down and it goes through this tube into the holding tank, and in the holding tank, solids settle out and anaerobic digestion starts. And as the solids begin to break down, they overflow and go through this constructed wetlands that's made out of old 55-gallon barrels.
For plants, Adam used
cattails and different rushes, and those seem to do really well, and so that's what I went with.
And he says the rocks are important too.
The rocks are providing surface area for all the bacteria and microbes to live on. The microbes and bacteria and plants start to break down the waste, and the plants use it as fertilizer.
The wastewater flows below the surface, pulled along by gravity. Actually, that's the trickiest part, Adam says, since the boat rocks. It's designed so that a flush will make its way through the system in about 30 days.
To this final cell here, which is a surface flow system, so there's water hyacinth and water lettuce and some other plants, and at that point the finished effluent is pumped out to irrigate these planter boxes here, and the water evapotranspires back up into the sky, falls back down on the roof as rain, and then goes through the system again. So it's a wastewater system, but there's no waste.
You can test for fecal coliforms, but there are low-tech indicators that the water's clean too.
You keep snails in it, and if the snails come out of the water, you know that there's something off in your system. But if everything, you know, so if these plants look healthy and are doing fine, you know that's a good sign.
While this is kind of a niche application of this technology,
a couple cities in the United States actually use constructed wetlands as their way of treating municipal sewage.
Poop and Paddle is still undergoing testing, and in case you're wondering, so far it does not smell. Adam hopes to display it this fall and is open to letting the public contribute to the project.
To-do list is build the toilet paper holder. I don't have that yet.
It's coming.
Yeah, coming soon. Toilet paper roll.
For Science Friday, I'm Flora Lichtman.